brought to you by CCT.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed the Road to Festival 65th Emancipation Celebrations. With me today is Mr. Ottley Hodge, one of the organizers of the Oceans of Blue Sapphire Honorees. Mr. Hodge, welcome to 284 Media.
Thank you.
Now, Oceans of Blue Sapphire Honorees. First of all, tell me where the concept came up for something of this magnitude.
Well, seeing that this is our 65th year and is leading up to be a grand one, we decided to use the same theme of the Sapphire for the 65th to be the honoree of the whole event.
Okay.
So what a better way to embed everything as one than using the 65th with Sapphire, which is symbolizes a Sapphire to do the honoree.
Now, for someone like yourself who's been involved in festival, being a part of the parade committee, been having music as a part of your life for a very long time, what do you think this means when you look back at the many years of Emancipation celebration, such a magnitude? What do you think this means for the Virgin Islands to be celebrating 65 years?
We've come a long way. You know, I think most of the time we take things for granted,
but
we try not to forget too much of what we come from, where we come from, because we have kind of gone over to the, most people have gone over to the business side of it instead of the
Do you think that's a bad thing though?
50-50.
Okay.
50-50. It depends on how you twist it.
Okay.
You know, but anything you do, and especially in this day and age, you have to spend. So you have to look at the business part of it.
I agree.
You know?
Honoring all generations, let's commemorate the 65th Emancipation celebrations. Tell me about this year's honorees that are going to be honored at the Sapphire dinner.
Well, I mean, we were asked to find a fundraiser to help, because the festival is quite a large
undertaking. Yeah.
Yeah. So, and with the parade committee, where the, let's say, the most spent, I would say, after the entire festival, because we don't really necessarily generate income. We more spend than we collect. So by the question or the ways of finding funding to help offset the cost, my committee and I sat down and we came up with this idea. And we said, what better way to show honoree to the people who've been there over the years, been helping out wherever they can, doing whatever they can, whenever they can, without any kind of recognition or any doing it for any favors or anything like that. They just did it because they wanted to. So we said, let's give them their roses, and this is the time to do it.
And who are these persons that we're going to be giving their roses?
Well, they are Kenesha Sprav, they have Jasmine Rudy, Myron Rubin, everybody knows them as Kunta. We have Lashing Dogs, Extreme Band, and last but not least, the Heritage Dancers.
All right. I think just from an outside perspective, it's quite a good cross-section when you look at the age difference, persons who might have been around for a very long time, and you have some younger persons in there. And for some reason, persons always feel that you have to be of a certain age to be honored. But I really like the fact that you guys are including some of the young participants of festival who made their contributions as well.
Right.
What can persons look forward to in coming to this event?
Well, again, it's basically we're trying to raise funds, but it's about honoring all of those people that I mentioned that did tremendous over the years. So we're gonna have a grand event. It's gonna be at the Moorings, and it starts at 6:30 in the night.
And that's July 14th, correct?
Yeah, July 14th, okay. That's this Sunday.
Okay.
You know, it's going to be something to remember. It's not just a one-year thing, too. We're trying to continue it. So hopefully next year will be there for the second annual and so forth and so forth. But we're going to try and make it as special as possible. We have some things lined up for throughout the night that will put it in his own place.
We're encouraging everyone to come out and support this very elegant and sophisticated event, honoring persons of all generations as we approach the 65th Emancipation celebrations. Mr. Hart, before you go, if there's anything you'd like to share with the general public, I'll let you give that opportunity.
We'd like everyone to come out and give your support. Even if you do not want to attend the event, you can sponsor the event or buy a ticket you know, give it to someone else, whatever the case may be. It's something, like I said, we are trying to do and trying to give honor to people while they're alive and then when they're gone. And hopefully it will be something that we can undertake again in the near future.
Awesome. Before you go, Mr. Hodge, I have one more question. There's oftentimes we realize when it comes to stuff like festival and committees, you find that it's quite a small cross-section of persons kind of really doing the work. A lot of persons like to sit on the sidelines and come to the parades, but they don't actually want to do the nitty-gritty, like, you know, putting in the planning and coming to committees stages. What encouragement would you give to not only young persons, but persons of all ages throughout the community as it pertains to celebrating and being a part of emancipation celebrations?
Well, I'll put it this way. You can't enjoy if there's no one there to put it together. You know, so as much as it's good to go and enjoy all the events, and when you finish, you go home and you're mm-hmm. happy, if there's no one there to put all the work together and make sure you have a good time, then it wouldn't make it, you wouldn't have nothing to go to. So, I mean, it's tedious because it's giving up your time for free. You know, it's not a paid position that you get. So it is challenging at times and you do get your stress. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, for me, just seeing people enjoying themselves and you put all that work in and you get the good feedback at the end of the day, it's all worth it. And I can't thank my committee enough. They have a strong committee in the parade committee, subcommittee, and they give me all they can. You know, and I couldn't do it over the years without them, and I can't thank them enough for all they've done for us.
Amazing. Well, we appreciate it and thank you for your service.
Thank you.
Is business slow, cash flow down, hosting an upcoming event? We can help. Advertise with 284 Media and take your business or event to the next level by enhancing your present marketing and messaging strategies. Allow our team of experts to create a personalized ad that sets your business apart from all the rest. This could be your business or event. So, what are you waiting for? Contact our marketing team at 284media@cctbvi.com. Advertising with us works.